slide and tube coagulase tests. Coagulase tests are used to differentiate coagulase positive Staphylococcus aureus from coagulase negative Staphylococcus species like Staphylococcus epidermides, Staphylococcus saprophyticus, etc. Coagulase is an enzyme which occurs in two forms, free and bound. Bound coagulase causes clot formation of the plasma by converting soluble fibrinogen to insoluble fibrin. This bound coagulase can rapidly be recognized by the slide test. Free coagulase converts fibrinogen to fibrin by activating the coagulase reacting factor and can be detected by tube test. Reagents and material required. Human or rabbit plasma with EDTA diluted 1 in 5 with normal saline. Clean, grease-free glass slides. Sterile test tubes. Quality control. A known strain of Staphylococcus aureus and Staphylococcus epidermides should be used as positive and negative controls respectively. Each batch of plasma should be tested with these control strains. Procedure for slide coagulase test. Take a clean grease-free glass slide and divide it into two sections using a glass marking pencil or a marker. Draw circles on the underside of the slide, designating the area where the test will be performed. Label one section as test and the other for normal saline control. This slide is a test slide. Take another slide, draw a circle on the undersurface and label it for the positive control. Place a drop of saline on each of the three circles. Pick 1 to 2 colonies from the test sample with a sterile inoculating loop and gently emulsify the colonies in saline on both sections of the test slide. Similarly, pick 1 to 2 colonies of a known strain of Staphylococcus aureus and gently emulsify in saline on the positive control slide. The emulsified colonies should look milky white in color. Now, place a drop of rabbit or human plasma on only one section of the test slide. Similarly, place a drop of plasma on the positive control slide. Gently rock the slides to and forth. Results and interpretation. A positive test is indicated by formation of white precipitate or clumps within 10 to 15 seconds of addition of plasma. The section of the test slide without the plasma should still look smooth and milky. If this section also develops clumps, then the result cannot be interpreted. Such strains should be further tested with the tube coagulase test. As the test sample also forms clumps like the positive control, it can be reported as coagulase positive Staphylococcus or Staphylococcus aureus. All strains testing negative for slide coagulase should be tested further by the tube coagulase test. Procedure for tube coagulase test. Take 0.5 milliliters of diluted plasma in two test tubes. Label one tube as the test and the other tube as positive control. With a sterile inoculating loop, pick 1 to 2 colonies of the test sample and inoculate in the tube labeled as test. Flame the loop. Similarly, pick 1 to 2 colonies of a known strain of Staphylococcus aureus and inoculate in the tube marked as positive control. Flame the loop again before keeping it aside. Incubate the test tubes at 35 to 37 degrees centigrade for 4 hours. Examine the tube after 4 hours. Results and interpretation. A positive tube coagulase test is indicated by the formation of a stable clot or coagulum, which is easily visible by slightly tilting the tube. If a test is negative after 4 hours, it should be further incubated at room temperature and observed again after 18 hours. If still the tube shows no coagulum, the test strain can be safely reported as coagulase negative.